Hello viewers, it's government time. I'll be taking you government SS class 3, prospects of government. The graduate of any government related course can work with government agencies. He can also be a teacher or a lecturer or a political analyst. These are some of the prospects. There are other prospects of a graduate of any government related course. We start with the importance of government. It helps people to know their rights and duties. It educates people about the form of government that is being practiced in their society. Again, it helps them to solve day-to-day problems. These are some of the importance of studying government. We'll start with the first main topic, federalism. What is federalism? Federalism can be traced back to 1914 when the Southern and Northern Protectorates were amalgamated. Since then, powers have been shared between the central, headed by the Governor General, and of course the government of the Northern and Southern Protectorates, headed by the Lieutenant Governors. Since then, the Nigerian setting has assumed a federal position. What are the factors necessitating federalism? Why is it important to make a state a federal state or to federate a state? One of the very important factors, especially as it obtains in Nigeria, is the differences in culture, religion, and language. Nigeria, for instance, being a multicultural society with a manifold religion and almost countless number of language, it is therefore necessary to federate a state like this, so that people are governed in the way that suits their culture, religion, and language. The second factor that necessitates federalism is to protect the interests of the minority group. Those that do not fall under the majority group would likely feel that they have been sidelined. But when a state is federated, it becomes easy for government to be brought closer to these people that feel that they are the minority groups. And finally, another important reason for federating a state is because of the wide population and the wide geographical area. For a state like Nigeria, where there is a whole vast area to be governed, when the state is federated, it becomes easy for governors to trickle down to the people in the grassroots. We shall now go over to the next topic, that is conferences organized by the colonial powers. What are these conferences organized by the colonial powers? First is the London Constitutional Conference of 1953. This conference, rather, was very necessary because of some of the defects of the Macpherson Constitution. One of those defects was that power was given to a lot of power was vested on the central government. And the powers given to the region were almost moribund. Why? Because the regions would have to have the law made by them approved by the central before those laws become operational. So such problem in the Macpherson Constitution was one of the problems that the London Constitutional Conference addressed. The next conference was the Lagos Constitutional Conference of 1954. This conference was organized to tackle some of the issues that were not properly taken care of during the London Constitutional Conference of 1953. Now, what are the agreements reached in this conference, especially the London Conference? First, that the legislative powers were shared between the federal, state, and the federating units. The second agreement was that Lagos be separated from the Western region and be made a neutral federal territory. These were two important agreements reached in the London Conference Constitution. The next is agreement reached in the Lagos Conference. We're going to mention two of them, a whole lot of them, but two very, very important too. One, that public service should be regionalized. Each region should have the public service extended to their region. And the second is the regionalization of the judiciary. These were very important agreements reached in this conference. That's the Lagos Conference. The next is the structure of the Nigerian federalism before the year 1960. That's before independence. Now, remember that amalgamation of the Northern and the Southern Protectorate gave Nigeria, like I said earlier, a federal color. But the 1954 Literates Constitution stipulates that power is shared between the central and regional government. Then from 1960 to 1966, the regions were increased from 3 to 4. Initially, we had the northern region, we had the western region, and we had the southern region. The northern region, the eastern region, and the southern region. Of course, during from 1960 to 1966, the Midwestern region was created from the western region. Then from 1967 to 1975, an attempt to forestall regional secession, Gowon divided the country into 12 states on May 27, 1967. Now, these 12 states were created from the four regions I mentioned: Midwestern region, the Western region, the Eastern region, and the Northern region. Of course, because the Eastern region then wanted to succeed, Gowon created 12 states from the four regions on May 27, 1966. And of course, after that, Muritala Muhammad actually added to this by making it 19. After that, two other states were created by Babangida: Katsina, if I remember vividly, Katsina and Akwa Ibom state. Okay. After that, in 1991 or thereabout, Abacha actually increased it to 36. And of course, here we are today with 36 states and of course the federal capital territory. Since 1967 till date, there has always been state creation, local government creation, to address the issue of minority group. Then we shall now briefly talk about problems of federalism in Nigeria. The problems of federalism in Nigeria is peculiar to the Nigerian society. First, the need for revenue allocation in the federal state. Revenue allocation has got to do with the sharing of allocation and of course other resources generated in the state. How do we share these resources in such a manner that certain group of people do not feel left out? That has been a problem of federalism in Nigeria. The second is revenue allocation formula. Of course, this takes from the first one. Which formula will be adopted to make sure that revenue is properly allocated without anyone feeling aggrieved? These have been problems facing the Nigerian federalism. Revenue allocation formula. A number of revenue allocation formula have been postulated by a number of commissions to help solve the problem resulting from revenue allocation. Now we shall be looking into a number of them, about 9 of them, but we shall be taking a number. The first is the Phillipson Commission of 1946. One of the recommendations of this commission is that we use the derivation and development formula for revenue allocation. Now, that will mean that any region that produces or from where we get a whole lot of revenue or a good amount of revenue, such regions should be given priority in revenue allocation. And of course, depending on the developmental issues in such a region. The next commission was one headed by Hicks Phillipson. So we call it the Hicks Phillipson Commission. And that was in the year 1951. Just like the Phillipson Commission we discussed earlier, the Hicks Phillipson Commission equally stipulated or proposed derivation, need, and national interests as a formula for allocating revenue. The next commission was one headed by Chicks, and it is called the Chicks Commission of the year 1953. Just like the other two commissions, the Hicks Commission stipulates or provides for derivation and fiscal autonomy depending on the physical or financial need of any region. And now, these are just about 3 of the commissions out of about 9 that was formed during the problems of revenue allocation in Nigeria, which of course has not been solved.